Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part one of solving nonlinear systems of equation. And in this video, first we review the three methods of solving linear systems of equation, and then we solve this nonlinear system using the substitution method. When we learned how to solve two linear systems of equations, we used the graphing, substitution, or elimination, often called the addition method. So the first method was the graphing method, and if they're linear equations, we were talking about two lines. So we would draw each line on the same set of axes and look for their intersection. Now this was just takes longer usually because sometimes it's not so easy to graph the lines and it's hard to tell exactly where they intersect. But the possibilities were either we would have two parallel lines, in which case there's no intersection and there would be no solution. Or we graphed one line and then we graphed the second line and it was exactly the same line, which means all the solutions on this line were solutions to that system, which means there were infinitely many solutions. Or, and this was the usual case, they would intersect somewhere and that point of intersection was the solution. The second method was the substitution method. This is where we solve for one variable in one equation and then we substituted that in for that variable in the other equation to solve for the second variable. And then we back substituted to find the other variable. When working with nonlinear systems of equation, this is a pretty good method to use. It's pretty accurate and most often used, I'd say, although the graphing method is also possible. And then we had also the elimination method. That's where we multiplied one or both equations by a constant so that when you added the two equations, one of the variables would be eliminated, and then we would go back and find the solution for the other variable to get our ordered pair. All of these would, if there was a single solution, it would be an ordered pair. So we can also use the elimination method with nonlinear systems of equations. Since when we're working with solving systems of nonlinear equations, we're generally interested in finding the points of intersection to find the ordered pair solutions. We'll only be interested in finding the real solution, since there are only real numbers on the x and y axis. And the graphical method wouldn't help us if we can't graph the non-real numbers. So if we solve for a variable and we get a non-real number such as 3i, or square root of I, or anything that has an imaginary number, we'll usually state that there is no solution, or at least that particular order pair would not be a solution. But in fact, there really is a non-real solution. We just wouldn't be able to see it on a graph. So in most classes, when you're asked to do these problems, solving systems of linear, non-linear equations, we won't be writing down any complex numbers in the ordered pairs, unless you're asked specifically to do that. So here's our first problem. Solve this system. Y equals x squared, 3x plus y equals 10. So we're trying to find the solutions that work in this equation. There might be none, there might be one, there might be two, there might be infinitely many, I don't know. But let's just think about what this looks like, each of these things. This first equation, y equals x squared, is a parabola going up. So you can get a picture, it's a parabola going up. And then we know that 3x plus y is a line, right? So what could happen? Well, maybe the line doesn't go through it at all. That's one possibility. That would mean there's no solutions. Or maybe it goes through it at two places. Or maybe it just touches it and I'm going to get one solution. So if you just think about it ahead of time, just that and nothing else, you could see that you're going to get zero, one, or two solutions. And this actually isn't too difficult to do by graphing. This is pretty simple and you could find the solutions by graphing. But I'm going to go ahead and first do this with the substitution method. And the reason I'm choosing that is because I've already solved in one variable. I mean, I've solved for one variable in one of my equations. So we've got that y equals x squared. So that means I could plug in x squared in for this y in the other equation. So let's do that. 3x plus, and we're going to replace the y with x squared. So I'm doing a substitution here, right? I'm plugging this in for y. All right, so now what do we have? We have a quadratic equation. So how do you solve a quadratic? You set the equation equal to 0, and then you see if you could factor it. So I'm going to get x squared plus 3x minus 10 equals 0, and factor. So let's see, I think that's going to be the combination 5 and 2, plus 5 and minus 2. So we set each factor equal to 0. All right, now remember, we're not looking for just x. We're looking for an ordered pair that is a solution to this system, one or more. So if x is negative 5, we should be able to find y by back substituting. That means you're going back to this equation right here and plugging in negative 5 for x. So when x is negative 5, we're going to plug in negative 5 for x. So we've got, remember this means negative 5 times negative 5, y is going to be 25. So when x is negative 5, y is 25. That gives me one solution. So one of my solutions, I'm going to use solution braces here, is when x is negative 5, y is 25. And we're going to check this to make sure later, but for now it looks like that's going to be it. All right, what about the other value of x? I got that x is 2. We also go back up to here and back substitute. So we have y equals, and we're going to plug in 2 for x. So we get y is 4. So just to make sure you see what was going on here, I was putting in negative 5 for this x right here, and then I was plugging in 2. Okay? So when x is 2, y is 4, so that's my other solution. So it looks like this one is going to intersect into two places. Now, looking at these solutions, you could see why graphically this might have been harder to do, because if I've got this solution, negative 5, 25, I'm going to have to have pretty big axes to get that, to see that solution. In other words, it's not going to work like, you know, by going, you know, over, you know, 6 and 6, because you're going to have the solution negative 5 all the way up to 25. So if you have a graphing calculator, it would be easy to see, or if you had a great big axes, you'd be able to see these solutions. So this can be done by graphing, but just realize after I see the solution here, I could see it would have been hard to see where it intersected on, you know, the normal sets of axes we're used to graphing. All right, let's go ahead and check that this is really the solution. Okay, so what does that mean? That means that this solution, negative 5, 25, must be a solution of both of the original equations. So let's check now. All right, so here was our original system right here. And these are our solutions, so we're going to check one at a time. So we're going to check that negative 5, 25 works in each of these equations. So we're going to plug in negative 5 for x and 25 for y. So I have 25 equals negative 5 squared, and that is true. Okay, so it works in that equation. Now we're going to put in negative 5 for x into the other equation, and that's the that's really the question, right? Does that equal 10? So I have negative 15 plus 25, and yes, that equals 10. So, because you know that that's 10 equals 10. All right, let's go over to the, so we know that negative 5, 25 is definitely a solution. All right, let's look at the next one. We're going to plug in 4 for y and 2 for x, and yes, that's true. 4 equals 2 squared. Then we're going to plug in 2 for x and 4 for y and ask if that's true. We've got 6 plus 4 is 10, and yes. Now, technically, you can go back. You could write it down all the way if you want. Write every single step, which makes makes it clear. You're just simplifying both sides and making sure that you get the same number on each side. So that is the solution to this first problem. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.